Hi, in this video I'll be discussing about group and role-based authorization in multi-tenant app. I have already created a video on the authentication part in the multi-tenant application. If you are interested, you can just go and check the link. I have put it out in the description and also on the screen. So let's just see what exactly does the authorization means. So this definition, I have taken it from the Wikipedia. So it says authorization is a function of specifying access right privileges to resources, which is related to general information security and computer security and to access control in particular area. So what does this mean is you are allowed to go at a place, but you are not allowed to check everything in the particular place. For example, let's say you are in an office, you are allowed to enter into office, but you are not allowed to go to all the rooms. So some access control is provided over there, which means you are restricted to go to some of the locations. So when we go and talk about the applications, some users might not be allowed to go and check all the pages. So that is called as authorization. You are allowed to go to the particular websites, but you are not allowed to go to all of those pages, all of those areas. That is, we call it as authorization. Before jumping and checking how exactly we will implement this authorization in the code, I just want to mention a couple of the things. First, I have already created two tenants, tenant 1 and 2, and respective users in the Azure Active Directory. If you want to understand how we create a tenant, you can go and check my video of authentication. There I've already described, I mentioned how to create the tenants. In this application, I'll be creating few roles, name it as Angular.NET Code, Java and React, which is required for the authorization part. And to achieve the authorization, I have to add some piece of code in the app roles in the application manifest. I will show you. So this is the basically the code which is required as per the documentation which Microsoft has provided. So we need to add the allowed member type as users, description we need to give the display name. This ID part is very important. This has to be unique. Then is enabled has to be true, language you can keep it as a null, origin, application. So this value is important. We are going to use this to compare it in the code. So please remember, this is case sensitive. So in the security group, we have to enter first some information in the manifest file. So that information is we have to mention the security group for the group membership claims. Also, we need to create a one group that I'll show you how to create that group. And we have to add some code in the startup file. Basically, we have to mention the policy. So policy, we'll name it as, let's say I've named it as admins. And then we'll mention in this policy. So the groups, these groups basically should be allowed to access the particular application or particular page of the application. So this is how we are going to achieve the security group. So let's just jump into the code and see how exactly this will work. Okay, so I am into Visual Studio. So let's go and create a new project. And I'll select ASP.NET Core Web Application. And I'll name it as role-based authorization. Click create. And in the authentication, click change, click work and school account and change it to multiple organization. And I'll select tenant 2, which I already showed it to you. So I've selected a domain as tenant 2. I'll click OK. And it will generate the boilerplate code, which is required for the multi-tenant application. So the application is created and let's just go and see the code which it has generated. So in the startup.cs file, you can go, it has added the authentication, basically the configuration which it is binding, app settings, and then it is adding the token validation. So basically it is false. We already have discussed about this in the multi-authentication app, and also some of the events it has added. This also we have discussed in the multi-tenant app. Okay, let's just go and see the app settings once. Okay, so these are the values which has added for the application. Now let's just go and see in the Azure Active Directory. Okay, I am into portal.azure.com, and since I've already mentioned I've created into the tenant 2, I have to switch to tenant 2, which I can by clicking here, switch directory, click tenant 2, switch. Go to view, click on app registration. Click on all application. So role based authorization is the application which we have created. So in this application, for the roles part, we have to go to the manifest. And in the app roles, we have to enter the roles whichever we want. So I'll go and I'll select. So this is the Microsoft document. I'll copy this particular and I'll put it in this app roles. And I'll add one more. And it should be users, and I'll name this as Angular, this also as Angular. You can give description as anything, I'll keep it the same. And again, another display name as .NET Core, same it in the value. And please remember the ID, it should be different, so I'll just keep some value here. Okay, the ID is different. I'll go and I'll save it. Okay, successfully updated. Now I'll go to the application. I'm into the code and I will show you with the different users. I am simply able to access the application. So I'll click on IIS Express. So if you can see, I have the access on the application. I am in the home. I can click on privacy so I can easily move to this particular page. So what I will go, I'll just stop this application and I'll go to the controller. So what I have to do, I'll just add the authorization here. And there I have to mention the roles. So the roles is, let's say, Angular. If somebody is having the Angular role, he should or she should be able to access that. So let me run it again. I'm in home. I'll click privacy access denied because this tenant 2 user is not part of the Angular 2 role. Okay. I'll go to the Azure portal again. And I have to map this particular users to the Angular role. And how I'll be doing, click on tenant 2, click on enterprise application. And you need to find the applications which you have just created, role based authorization. Go to users and groups, add user group, select none selected. And there you can select the tenant 2. Select here and select a role. So basically the roles which we have created are coming here. Select Angular, click select, assign. So tenant 2 now has the role as Angular. So what I will do, I'll go and run the application again. I'm in the home. I'll click privacy. Access is still denied. So basically, I have to sign out and then I have to re-log in because the token is cached. And I'll go and sign in again. Some password. Yes. Go to privacy. Cool. So I have the access. Now let me go and log in with the tenant 1 and we will see how the role based will works for tenant 1. Since tenant 1 user is not part of tenant 2, I'll do first sign out. Click sign in. Okay, so I have logged in with the tenant 1. Now if I go and try to access the privacy, access is denied because the Angular role is not added to the tenant 1 user. Now how to add that? Let me go to the portal.azure.com and right now I'm into tenant 2. I have to jump to the tenant 1 switch. I'm inside tenant 1. Go to Azure Active Directory. Go to enterprise application. you will be able to see all those application to which the tenant one has the access or tenant one has logged in. The tenant one has just logged in. So this is the reason load based authorization is coming here. Click. Go to users and groups. Now here it is showing the default access this particular user has on role based authorization application, because tenant one has logged in into role based authorization application. Now if we want to add any role, click on add user, click on this none selected, click on tenant one, select this none selected again. Now Angular and .NET Core is appearing in this particular location. So this is how you can assign any role which we have created in the tenant 2, but we can assign it to tenant 1 users. So let me click on Angular, click select, clicks assign. Now tenant 1 user has two roles, one is the default one and another is the Angular. So let me go to the application, stop, and let me run it again, and we'll see if tenant 1 is able to access the privacy or not. Okay, so tenant one is logged in, home, privacy access denied. So let me just sign out and sign in again. Sign in. Enter the password, confidential password. Click privacy. Cool. So tenant one is now able to access the privacy. So this is how we can assign the role base in the multi-tenant app. Only the global admin or the admin of the tenant one has the access to assign the roles. So inside tenant two, we cannot assign any role directly to the tenant one user. Now we will see how to create a groups and restrict with the groups. So what I'll be doing, I'll go to Azure portal. So I'll go to tenant two first, and I'll click on groups, and let us create a new group, and let us give the name as the admin, and description is not required, and just click create. Everything should be the same. Now admin group is created. Now we want that every user who is part of this particular group should be able to access the application. And how we will be doing that, let me go to the code, stop the application and go to startup. Now I've already mentioned we need to add in the app manifest the group membership claim as security group, and then some code. We need to complete these two steps. So first we will go to the app manifest, so let me go to app registration, go to role based authorization, click on app manifest. So I mentioned you, we have to in the group membership claim mention the security group. This you can also come and find it out on this particular page. Here is it. You need to add security group. Copy from there. Paste it here. So group member security group you have added in the group membership claims. Save it. Now go to your code. You need to add the code, some code here. So I already have the code. I'll just paste it here. So what does this code says is we need to add authorization, and this authorization should have the policy. So I've named that policy as admins. You can just name it as admins or any other name also, that is okay. And in the claim you need to mention, I want the groups. So here you need to the ID of the group. So to find the ID, go back to the Azure, go to the tenant 2, click on groups, click on admin, and this particular ID you need to copy. Go back to your code, paste it over there. Okay, so this code is added. Now go to controller. Instead of roles, you just need to mention the group name. So the group name is admins. I think it is admins. Okay, so we are good. Save, run the application. Now I have not added any user in the admin group. It should not allow anyone to access the privacy. So let's just go and see. Click on privacy, access denied. Now I have to go and add the tenant to under the admin group. Then this tenant too will be able to access the privacy. And to do that, let me go to Azure and go to groups. Click on the group. Click on members. Add member. Search for tenant 2. Select. So the member is added. Now go back to your code. Sign out. Sign in. Enter the password. So now I am able to access with the tenant 2. So tenant 2 now has the access. So this is how we can achieve role based and the group based authorization. To assign the groups to the user who is not part of tenant 2, what we have to do? Go to the active directory of tenant 2, click on users, click new guest users. Now here you need to create a user or you need to invite, since I already have created one user. So what I'll be doing, I'll just mention the email address. Now below you need to select the group to which you want to give the access. So if I click admin, so whenever this user logs in and if he tries to go to any place where the admin has the authorization, then this user can easily go to particular page also. So select invite. So first the user has to accept the invitation, then he needs to log into the application with the same credentials. So the invitation is there, and accept the invitation. So I'll go and I'll run the application, and then I'll try to log in with the user too, and I'll try to go to the privacy page. Enter the credential of user 2, enter password. Now this user is going to log in first time. So what it has to accept the permissions, click accept. Cool. So this user has access to privacy. I want to mention one thing. Why I have not invited tenant 1 user? Because let me go to users, new guest users. And if I enter the login ID of the tenant 1, it says it's not a valid email address, because this is just the login which we are using to connect to any application. And since it's not an email address, it cannot send the invite. So this was the reason I have created another user, just to show how we can add any different user into the groups. Thank you. And the last important thing, if you are liking the content, if you like this video, please do subscribe, share, and press the bell icon, and do share it with your friends. Thank you.